interesting.
Yes, sir. My patient Siddhanna Bijur, 62-year-old male patient, has a 20-year-old post-traumatic stiff elbow with a fixed contracture with 20 degrees of fixed flexion deformity. Further flexion up to 120 degrees, probably secondary to a malunited radial head fracture with the restriction of supination terminally. And he's currently presents with pain and with pain in the left elbow and disability in the form of the inability to carry heavy weights since last 1 month. It's a 20-year-old fixed flexion contracture, secondary to a malunited radial head fracture, sir. 20 years old injury, sir. Sir, after recent 1 month, he has developed pain. He had a contracture since 20 years, but recently has developed pain.
So what is it? How much is the FFD?
The fixed flexion deformity is of 30 degrees and further flexion up to 120 degrees is possible.
So he has an FFD of 30 degrees?
Yes, sir.
So that's his problem right now?
Yes, sir. And pain is the problem right now, sir.
Pain
and his inability to carry heavy weights.
Pain increased since last?
Since last 1 month.
Before that, absolutely no pain?
Normal. No pain, sir.
So has the deformity increased?
So the deformity is same since 20 years, yes sir.
30 degree of FFD since 20 years and last month he, 1 month he has pain, that's
yes,
all.
Yes sir.
Unable to carry heavy weights because of pain or weakness?
Pain and weakness both.
No, both are different. If it is weakness then we are looking at something else. If it is pain we are looking at something else.
There is a component of weakness secondary to disuse.
How is this median nerve, ulnar nerve, radial nerve?
The nerves are normal. Neural
nerves
examination.
Are normal, then why it is weakness?
So because of disuse.
Why it has become painful? What is your diagnosis as far as the pain is concerned? Is it a radiohumeral arthritis?
Arthritis, yes sir. Radiocapitular arthritis.
You come out with the diagnosis that this.
You come out with the diagnosis that this is a radiohumeral arthritis secondary to the whole malunited.
Radial head fracture. Yes.
Sure?
Yes, arthritis.
Why he has done after 20 years?
Any trauma recently? Which
no re-trauma, sir.
Why do you say radial humeral? Can it be ulnohumeral? Because the ulnohumeral is a joint, normal joint.
The 3-point bony findings. Examination
findings like?
What? I'm sorry, sir.
What are the findings?
Findings are, so there is tenderness over the anconeus triangle.
That is your positive finding to say it is a radiohumeral arthritis rather than ulnohumeral. Is that the finding?
Tenderness
yes,
is only
tenderness,
posterolaterally?
Tenderness over the radial head, sir.
And on the posterior aspect?
No tenderness, sir. Absolutely no tenderness.
Anterior aspect?
No tenderness.
Medial side?
No, sir.
Is there any thickening over the ulna?
Ulna nerve?
No, the ulna.
Ulna.
Olikrana.
No, sir. No.
Olikrana.
Sir, there is a thickening over the. No, sir. There is no thickening.
Was it an old olikranon fracture and that now it has gone into an ulna humeral arthritis?
Sir, there is no evidence. He didn't say he pinpoints pain at
no,
the.
On your examination, did you find any pathology with the trochlea or olikranon?
No, sir, I have not found any pathology.
So, your ulnohumeral joint is intact.
Yes,
that is what you say.
Yes, sir.
There is no tenderness, there is no thickening of the ulna.
No, sir.
So, your ulnohumeral joint is intact. Your only pathology is in the radial head.
Radial head.
Okay, around the radial head. What about supination pronation?
Supination is terminally restricted by 30 degrees.
There is restriction of supination.
Supination.
Pronation?
Pronation is full.
Full. So, there is terminal restriction of supination.
Supination.
Okay, how will you proceed now?
I would investigate the patient in the form of radiographs.
X-ray?
So, X-ray of the left-sided elbow. left-sided elbow showing a malunion at in the radial head.
What is more obvious?
Arthritis, sir, of the elbow joint.
Of the elbow joint?
Of the radiocapitellar joint, sir.
And what about the ulna humeral? See the lateral half of the ulna humeral.
Stand upright. Correct. Stand upright. Now.
See here. From here to here. And here also.
There is, yes sir, there is evidence of arthritis in the ulna also.
So you say the ulna humeral is also involved?
Yes sir, possibly. On the x-rays.
Lateral view, the ulna humeral joint looks relatively okay, right? Yeah. Now, Dr. Sudhir, what do you think in the lateral view?
Ulna humeral it looks quite alright, but then you can see only half of the joint here even, lateral also. If you see it here, it is impinging at the trochlea here.
Now is that possibly because of the FFD? Because he has an FFD of 30 degrees. Maybe they were not able to take a full extension view. Because here it looks, the space is relatively intact.
This.
Is the ulna, is the flexion painful or not? From 30 to 100 degrees of flexion, is it painful or not?
No sir, it's not.
Absolutely
painful.
No pain.
Absolutely not, no pain sir.
30 to 120, no?
Yes,
120.
Sir. 30 to 120.
So 30 to 120 ROM is painless.
Painless sir.
No spasm.
No, so no spasm sir.
You can even feel an osteophyte which is coming from that. This is not over the radius at all. See, this is the most tender point.
Actually,
so it's probably old elbow injury with developing ulnohumeral arthritis as well.
So, Nagesh, you feel that it is more of a ulnohumeral arthritis?
That is all right, but this process is going on for last 20 years. He had some major accident which involved lower extremity, so he didn't take any treatment for this, and he had some fracture or intra-articular something, or I don't know, which has led to some irregularity and elbow deformity like this, and that is gradually increasing, and now that has increased to a level that it is developing pain. So I feel it is more of a ulnohumeral arthritis as well. Clinically, you
elbow.
Can, yeah, you can even little extension also you get.
Now, even if you see the radial head, it does not show any radial head old injury, except that there is an osteophyte. This osteophyte, but you do not see any evidence of old injury here in the neck or the radial head.
Now, what I mean to say is by just doing something to the radial head and excision is not going to improve his function.
Yeah.
So that is a question. How old is he?
He is 62, sir.
So the question is whether it's going to change your treatment. If there's ulnohumeral arthritis, your treatment is going to be
the range
significant,
of
different.
So what are you going to do? What is your plan of treatment?
So what I will do, taking into consideration is age and whatever occupation. He is right now a retired person. So, sir, I would excise the radial head, sir, because sir, the range of motion is full,
exactly,
sir.
Exactly, that is what Dr. Nagesh.
Sir, Dr. Naik showed that excising the radial head will not solve the problem because he feels it is more of an ulnohumeral pain.
Actually, the range of motion
is painful. Painful. You attempt.
Sir, where is the tenderness?
Maybe, but pain may not go.
Lateral side of the ulna.
Yeah.
is able to.
Taral, so excision of radial head
attempting
will not
extension is painful, no? He has a pain at the ulnohumeral joint.
Okay, to avoid the what any further investigations will you do? See, according to Dr. Nagesh, it is the ulnohumeral joint. The whole entire elbow is involved, not the radial head alone.
Yes, sir.
So if you excise the radial head alone, the symptoms will remain the same.
Yes, sir.
So you have to address the entire elbow rather than the local part of it. So what will you do?
Actually,
will you do any further?
Yes, sir. I would investigate in the form of an MRI also.
MRI. I can. MRI hai? No.
Kunal, MRI hai ka? MRI is not there, sir. It's not MRI has not been done.
So he has come yesterday.
Yes.
Because we have a difference in opinion. Two of us feel that it is primarily a radio capitular arthritis.
Radiohumeral.
Yeah, radiocapitular, whatever.
Yeah.
Radiohumeral, and the because we can see a normal joint space in the ulnohumeral joint. There is sclerosis, of course, but there is no irregularity. There are no other signs of arthritis except for this finding, which could be still be due to a fixed flexion deformity. The X-ray has not been taken properly. It was not in full extension. So this, yeah. So,
Hitesh, clinically he has a tenderness.
Yeah, I agree. There is a small difference in correlation between clinical and radiology.
And attempted extension is
according to
painful.
His finding, there is a 30 to 120 degree of free
painless range of motion.
So that says that the ulnohumeral joint is not arthritic. According to what we learned from clinics, if there is a painless free range of motion without spasm,
clinically
means ulnohumeral joint is
normal.
Intact. And rotations are restricted primarily due to your radial head,
yes,
arthritis,
sir,
as well as an old malunion.
So the range of motion is in the functional range. What he can manage his daily activities.
So in that scenario, why just a radial head excision would suffice, right?
Yes, sir.
So that is was two of us opinion. I don't know what is the consensus.
I agree. We have to explain to the patient you have two problems. One is of not being able to extend the last 30 degree and restriction of the last 30 degree of supination. So if you want that extra 30 degree supination, the radial head excision will solve that. It will not allow you to extend your elbow unless you do another excellency if you have an osteophyte on the posterior aspect of the olecranon, which probably excision may help. But definitely excision of the radial head will help achieve more supination. Yeah, but that's a functional range. So only excision of the radial head will help him achieve good supination.
How do you explain the tenderness at the ulnar side rather than there is no tenderness over the radial head?
The problem
is in the anconius triangle. He says the tenderness in the anconius triangle. And look, where is the articular surface of the ulna? It is very close to the anconius triangle. So it is very difficult to say clinically that it is radiocapitular joint and ulnohumeral joint tenderness. Okay, it's extremely difficult. So that is the only positive finding to say there is ulnohumeral arthritis.
Yes, sir.
Other than that, I don't think you can say there is ulnohumeral.